back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this tier dress, this step-by-step dress. So like the one on the picture, you can see it has three steps. I'm going to be telling you guys the basics of making this hair. Just pay attention and you will understand it is very, very simple. So I'm just going to tell you guys how to make it and then show you guys an illustration of how to do that. So first thing you're going to do is, if you want to make this dress, you start from your basic bodice, right? So guys, the first thing you're going to do to get the measurements you need here is to subtract your shoulder to your waist, shoulder to the end, maybe your ankle or to the floor, the length of the dress. So let's say the length of your dress is 50, and then your shoulder to your waist is 16, right? This part to this part is 16, this top to this your shoulder to the floor is 50. That means that 34 is going to be length of this bottom, right? So that means 34 is going to be, so now we've gotten what this lower part of the dress would be. So that's how you're going to calculate it. To make these three layers, right, what you can do is, is left to you to determine the length you want to work with, right? You can make, let's say you got 30 to be the length of your bottom dress, you can decide to use 10 inches at the first square, another 10 inches, right, another 10 inches. I'm talking about just the length. You decide to use 10 inches 10 inches and then 10 inches to get your total length. It depends on you if you want the three of them to be the same square, like the same length of the square, up, right? If that makes any sense. So you want the square to be the same length. So you want 30 is the length you're working with, and you want each block to be the same square. Then you can divide it into 10, 10, 10. Nobody can divide what you want to use for you. It is left for you to decide. Maybe you want the upper one to be smaller. So you can go ahead. If you want the upper square to be smaller, now we are talking about just the length. So you want the upper square to be smaller. You can decide to use like how this one on this picture is now. You see the upper is smaller. And then I think the center is slightly bigger, longer than the lower one. Or the two of them, I think the two of them are the same length, I'm not sure. But what you can do, it depends on you. So let's say you're working with 30. You can decide to use, okay, the top one, I want it to be, you want your top one to be, let's say, 6 inches of length. And then you want the, it's remaining 24 now, right? So you can now divide, if you remove this 6 from the 30, now you have 24. So you can now decide to make the rest 12, 12. Of length. Nobody can decide this length for you. It's left to you. If you want to make this, you just come out and think, okay, the length I have to decide on is total of, let's say total of 30, like I said before, and I want the top one to be smaller, I want the middle one to be bigger. It's left for you to divide everything and then check it and make sure that it comes out to the total of what you want on your calculator. So now that we've decided how to make the length, we're now going to talk about how to make the width. So guys, to make the width is just standard, the same thing for everybody. So let's say the waist, the weight is going to start with the waist, right? So the first layer is attaching to the waist of the top part of your body, sorry, the lower part of your body. So let's say you divide everything and your waist is 20 inches waist, right? So what you need, gather that will go around this 20 inches. Sometimes people don't normally use gather for their first layer. Sometimes they might make something that looks like a line. And then the next ones will now start coming in with gather. But let's say in this instance that you're making something that will start with gather right from the beginning, right? You see how this one, like this one now, we started with gather right from the waist of these bodies. It started with gather. So what you're going to do is, let's say this is your waist measurement that you're working with. That's all you need right now. You're to multiply it by 1.5. So 20 times 1.5. This is the first layer, layer number one. So we are working with layer number three layers here, right? 1, 2, 3. You're going to go layer number two, layer number three. So whatever you get from this 20 times 1.5, each layer, you're going to multiply by 1.5. So you see, your waist is what you're attaching this bottom part to, right? So you have that 20 that is your waist in this instance, and you're going to multiply it by 1.5. So 20 times 1.5, you have 30, right? So now 30 is what you're working with for the next layer. So you bring down that 30 again. 30 is going to be what you need to attach it. So you're going to bring down that 30 and you're going to, sorry, you're going to multiply that 30 again times 1.5. So the next layer is going to be 45 inches longer. You see? And then you bring down that 45 inches back down here again. And then, sorry, times 1.5 times another, sorry, times 1.5 again to get this layer. So 45 times 1.5, so 67.5 is what you need for the next layer. You can bring down this 65 if you want 4 layers. That's how you're going to keep going. 1.5 times 1.5 times, that's what you need for the width. This one here now is the width, how long the flay you're going to need. So that means the first one, the width of my fabric, that's the width this way, is going to be 30 inches. The second step, the width of it is going to be 45 inches. The third step, the width of it is going to be 67.5 inches. So that's how you're going to keep going. So guys, for the purpose of this illustration here, the waist I'm going to be working with, my bodies that I'm going to cut immediately after this one now will be 16 inches, the waist of the body of that bodies. And then, you see, my first layer is going to be that 16 times 1.5. So what I got for that is 24. And then my next layer is 24 times 1.5. We gave me 36, which is the width of this one here. The width of the first one is 24. And then this 36 from the second layer, which is my second layer. So this is my first layer. This is my second layer. And then my third layer is going to be that 36 from this second one times 1.5, which gave me 54. So you see, as I keep going, my length, the width is increasing for me. So now, the next thing you're going to do that I forgot to say is, for the length here, whatever you decide to use as your first layer, you're going to add extra one to it. So let's say you decide to use, like that first illustration that we're saying 30, that is the length of the total length that you need, and you divided it into 10, 10, 10. What you're going to do is, you're going to add 1 to the 10 in the first layer. So you're going to add 1 to it. The reason for that 1 is because you want half an inch at the top here to join it to your bodice or to join it to the band of your skirt. And then you want another half an inch at the bottom to accommodate this second layer to it, right? So that's why you add 1 inch to it. Half an inch for joining it to the bodice, half an inch for joining the lower part to the lower part. Then the next layer following it, you also add, so you're going to add plus 1 to the length, plus 1 to the length. But when you come down to the last one, no matter how many layers you have to it, keep adding plus 1, plus 1, because all you need is half an inch to join the top part, half an inch to join the lower part. Remember, we're talking about the length, not the width, the length. So, but the lower part, what you're going to add to it is plus 1.5 to the length. You're going to add plus 1.5. Plus 1.5 is because you need half an inch for joining it to the upper part. But then you need one inch for folding the end. You need 1 inch for folding it, like how you normally end up everything. Like when you're folding your clothes, that you normally fold one and then you fold again. It's 1 inch that you normally use to do that. So that is why you need 1.5 to add to the length of the lower, the last final layer of this, you add 1.5. But every other one going up is going to be plus 1 inch. So guys, now to join it, all you have to do is, I'm going to go ahead and notch. You see, I've made this thing and I folded each layer into two. I understand that most of your fabric might not cut, the width might not be enough. So which means you have to join. You have to join to get, especially coming to the lower one, you have to join multiple times to get that length, that width that you need. So what you're going to do to distribute this is just to divide, notch it halfway through. So fold it into two and notch it up and down. Do the same thing on the second layer, notch it up and down after folding it into two. And then you're going to know that this notch here from this one, so you see this notch here is going to meet up with this particular notch here. Sorry, let me put it this way so that you guys can see. So you see there's a notch at this top part here, and then there's a notch on the first layer. So you know that when you distribute your gather, this is to help you distribute it evenly. All this part here is going to pleat into this part. All this part here is going to pleat it into this part. So that way you've shared everything into two equal parts. This one, you're going to pleat it here. This one, you're going to gather it into this part. The same thing for the next layer also. So guys, as you can see, I've gone ahead and joined this. So, and to join it, remember, you each step you're adding, you will not go, okay, so this is the lower part of the first step. You see, it's straightened out. And then the second one is what was pleated on top. So you see, you join it and then you gather it. This, the third step, you see, the one after that, the lower part of each flay will not be gathered as well as the upper part. So each one you're going to attach, you're going to just gather only the one below it. The lower layer of it is never gathered. It's just the one that is going to join to it that is gathered. So you see, the lower layer of my first one is not gathered. It's just the second part of it that is gathered. The lower layer of my second layer here is not gathered. It's just this last one that is gathered on top, if that makes any sense. So now this part here will also be gathered to join my upper bodies. And to cut my bodies, this is what I'm going to be using here. So guys, to do this here, what you have to do is just cut out what you need for your basic block bodies, right? You're going to check your shoulder to your waist measurements. You get that. So for me, let's say I'm working with this here about 9.5 or so. So what you're going to do is go ahead. The width you're going to fold your fabric is your bust divided by 4 plus 1. So what you're going to do is go up to your shoulder, mark 3 inches, then mark your shoulder. Let's say my shoulder width is, your shoulder measurement is 14, but because you're going to be making it sleeveless, you might want to come in by 1.5 or 1 inch in total. So I'm going to, instead of using my shoulder measurement divided by 2, which is going to give me 7, I'm going to work with 6 because it's going to be sleeveless, or you can even work with 5.5 somewhere here, and then you're going to come in here putting your armhole divided by 2. So I'm going to act like minus 10 divided by 2 is 5. Give it your armhole curve. Come in here. Your neckline is 3. You're going to use the basic that we use for neckline. So you're going to work with 3 by 3. So I'm going to work with 3 by 3. And then mark it here. Give it a curve also. Come down here. Your waist measurement divided by 4. So whatever you get. So let's say I got 6. My waist measurement divided by 4, I got this. You're going to add extra 2 inches to it. So that's going to be at this point here. You connect it here and then go down by 1 inch for your back neckline. So this here, I'm just rushing through it to show you guys because I feel like the most work is at the bottom part. And then you're going to go ahead and cut everything out. So you're going to first cut out your armhole. You came down 1 inch here for your shoulder slope. So this is just how you cut your basic bodice, is what you're using here. This is where my darts will come in. Your nipple to nipple measurement divided by 2. So let's say my nipple to nipple measurement is 6 divided by 2 is 3. So it's somewhere here. And then you're going to measure your shoulder to your bust. And let's say my shoulder to my bust is 6. Your dart is going to stop 1 inch before that. So my dart is going to stop at 7. So that's where my dart will stop. But your dart at the back is going to go up to your chest line. At the back is going to follow this same trail, but it's going to go up even further. It won't stop 1 inch before my bust line because my bust doesn't, I don't have any bust at the back. So after that, you're going to just give 1 inch here, 1 inch, sorry, half an inch, half an inch, and then connect it. So this is what you're, notch it and distribute it all the layers. So now I'm going to go ahead, join the shoulder, put in my dart, and close up the armhole. You can use bias to close up this, but the next thing I'm going to show you guys is how to do the neckline. So guys, as you can see, I've joined everything. You're supposed to use bias to finish the armhole sleeve here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just show you guys how to do the neckline. So to do the neckline, you're going to go ahead and measure around your neck, right? Measure around your neck and make sure that, and then you fold this into two this way, right? And then try to measure and make sure that your neckline fits in here. But remember, you still have your zip allowance here. So you just measure it and check that if you take away your zip allowance, will this still fit your neckline before you add that band? So you're going to measure and make sure that this can fit your neck. Once you check that, you go ahead and get the band you're going to use for the neckline. So guys, because if you look at the picture, the band is not that long. I would advise you to use like 3 inches width, so that when you fold it, you have 1.5 on each side, and then you use the half an inch to join it, and then your band will be just 1 inch neck line. Except you want your band to be wider than that, then you can use 4 inches width, and then when you fold it, and after everything, you might have 1.5. It depends on you if you're going for a turtleneck or if you're just going for what is on the thumbnail. I'm going to use for the neckline. I'm just going to fold it into two this way, and then I'm going to join it. How you're going to join it is, remember, you've measured it, you know the length you need now. So you're going to start with the zip allowance. So whatever you measured for around your neck, if it's not enough and you feel like it will be tight when you finish it, you go ahead and chip off a little bit, like 0.2, to open up the neckline again. But start with the front and chip off and blend it in, and check again. You chip off a little, blend it in until you figure out that it's okay. So because if you go ahead and chip off 1.5 all the way around to the neckline, it will open it up wider. So just blend it in, chip it off a little bit here, and then check and see if it's okay. So now what I'm going to do is just start from one side of the neck and take this band this way, and then I'm going to sew it. So I'm going to start one side of the neck. I'm going to sew this all the way around. So guys, you see I've attached it all the way through the band. So you're going to go ahead and notch it now, pull it up. If you want, you can go ahead and top stitch it. But at this point here, you're going to go ahead and join. So now my basic bodice, the top part is done. I'm going to go ahead and join. You see my dart is here. It's also at the back. I'm going to go ahead and join this here. But remember, you notched it. So you're going to start with the center to the center. So the center of this is going to join to the center of this. All my seams opening will go to the back. So I'm going to have one long opening at the back here, which is going to be for my zip. And my zip is going to go all the way to the top part here. So guys, this is what it looks like right now. So you see, so if you use your body measurement, it will come out nice. So you go ahead and put in the zip at the back here. So that's basically how you do it. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any question, just leave it in the comment section, because my next video is also going to be the same layered dress, but this time around it's going to have button in front, and it's going to have like a shirt look at the top part with sleeve. So if you have any question, just leave it in the comment section so I can answer it in the next video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Bye.